CBS 3 Eyewitness News at 6.
Family of a Penn sophomore who died of meningitis last September is looking for accountability tonight. They filed a lawsuit against the hospital of the University of Pennsylvania, charging malpractice. CBS 3's Pat Chiracchi is live outside the hospital with the story. Pat?
Well, Larry, it was back on September the 6th that 19-year-old Ann Ryan came here to the hospital of the University of Pennsylvania emergency room, in order to be treated because she was very sick. She had a high fever of 103. She had a stiff neck. She had a very bad headache. She did get treatment here, but 3 days later, she was dead, and now her family's attorney says that she was misdiagnosed, and that was a fatal error. Ann Ryan was a dark-haired beauty. So pretty, in fact, she was a cover girl for Penn's modeling club. On September 6, 2007, Ann presented with what her lawyer says were all the classic symptoms of bacterial meningitis. Doctors saw that too. They tested for it, but the tests weren't conclusive.
She had laboratory blood results which pointed to her having meningitis, and she was discharged with a diagnosis of a viral infection.
2 days later, Ann's brother brought her back.
She was gravely ill by that point. She had swelling in her brain, and in the face of the swelling in her brain, she ended up having a lumbar puncture, which led to a herniation of her brain.
And her death. In a lawsuit filed today, attorney Tom Klein alleges that the hospital made a fatal error.
If she had been kept in the hospital and if she had been put on antibiotics, there is no doubt in my mind that she'd be alive today.
And we're not going to try this in the media.
Still, Dr. Patrick Brennan, Penn's chief medical officer, told me some issues are being mischaracterized.
And we've got a team of physicians and nurses here who are expert in emergency medicine and the diagnosis and treatment of conditions like this, and they did everything that they could to try to avert this tragedy.
Well, the Ryan family attorney did tell me that they are seeking monetary damages. The next step is getting the sworn testimony in a deposition of the physicians who cared for Ann in her last hours. Reporting live from the hospital of the University of Pennsylvania, Pat Chiracchi, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Pat, thank you.